Friends, this is Boys Noize, DJ and producer from Berlin. We're gonna check out some of the comments you've been writing on my sets. Honestly, I never read them. I haven't even watched any of my sets all the way through. I'm just generally not so interested in watching myself DJ. I just hate looking at myself.
Next act needs no introduction. We have Boys Noize.
Okay, I think I watched that one actually. Oh, what? Oh, oh! Yes, yes. Oh my god. We split it, yes! Damn. It smells so good. Oh my. You know, I know those guys too. They're actually the nicest girls, man. I always see them in Belgium. But that's next level. I mean, whatever makes them happy, but that's crazy. It's like every week they get a fresh one. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Could have been her. She's so cool, man. Lady Gaga is dope, I have to say. I mean, she's definitely one of the coolest artists I met that is like so famous, like ridiculously famous, but so down to the ground and so cool. You know what she asked me? She was like, "Do you know Surgeon?" And I'm like, are you fucking with me? Like, Surgeon? She's like, "Yeah, he's Tony, he's my friend. He opened up like some of my shows." I'm like, are you crazy? That's so cool. But yeah, she's down to techno. And what's crazy too is like, she got into modular stuff now too. I brought my modular system. She spilled water on it right away. But it kind of broke the ice, I guess. And then we wrote a fucking hit, I think. But now she's into modular. She bought a system, and you know, I went back to Berlin and came back. She had a whole system, and we used that on some of the songs. And she's all about it. It's really cool.
Thank you so much. There's a new.
That's the one with Jackson. Yeah. Fuck yeah! I mean, Jackson is a good friend of mine. Jackson is Computer Band. Yeah, he's a crazy sound nerd. And he looks fucking good as well. 2 days before that night, he called me and he was like, "Alex, I have an idea. Let's make a full album for the night." And I'm like, okay, yeah, good idea. Every track was 120 BPM. That was sort of the rule. And yeah, we made our album and we played it out. And it never came out, but you can check it out in the set. Shit. Yeah, you know, we only make love after. Oh, did he? Oh, damn! Don't come too close. I mean, you gotta understand at these parties, I think every boiler room, the sound basically next to me is shit. Like you don't hear much, and so sometimes, you know, you just mess up and mix, but you know, for me that's fine. But when you play back to back, like I feel like it's my job to like make sure the whole thing is going right, so I might go in and like save a situation like that. But yeah, that's what, something I watch when too many DJs are playing. Like, they always look out for each other, you know? Yeah, so that was in the very beginning of Boiler Room. That boiler room was fun because the, you know, it was in the early days of boiler room where you guys were telling me, do a DJ set, like if it was in your bedroom and you're doing a mixtape for your friends, playing records that you usually don't play. So that was the whole idea about boiler room.
Now to everyone at home who's asking if Joey played Energy Flash. Yes, he did.
So I packed a whole bag of records. All my, basically every record was my favorite record. And I showed up. You guys had the wrong fucking mixer. I have more than 20,000 records at home. I'm a vinyl addict. And plus I was working in a record store for like 5-6 years. Underground Solution, shout out to Ollie. I have so many labels almost complete. Even like Guy Dance Records or like, you know, like all this, like or Glasgow Underground or I don't know, all the Moody Man, Theo Parrish stuff. That's all the stuff I started with, but yeah, I still have them. Oh.
We're in the house of bands.
That was so mad, man. So who was playing? It was Mode Selector, Gazafelstein, Brudinski, and me.
Who's coming up next? Boys Noize.
Oh, Hercules as well. That's dope. Yeah, and I just put out all these records. I'm testing a few of mine. That's your opinion, man. Yeah, I had a mustache there, right? I don't have much hair, facial hair. I only have a baby mustache sometimes. I'm glad you don't really see it, because it kind of looks My mustache is a, you know, is a funny relationship with me and the mustache, because I don't have much hair in my face. So the only thing that grows is my, probably my eyebrow and my mustache. Yeah, I mean, basically every boiler room is mad like that. Like the people are just so close next to you. I'm usually good with that situation. I don't know. I'm just doing my thing. But again, it's so hard sometimes because you don't hear the monitor. So that's when you mess up mixes. It's like you don't hear it and it falls over and stuff like this. And there's my records that, yeah, because people were like running over it. I'm like, guys, please, there's some rare ones in there. I don't notice anything, honestly, like when I play. What's going on? Where's the lighter? Oh, shit. He's like, this is lit. Yeah, you never know who drank the bottle before, so I'm like, take the first zip and spit it out or some shit. I don't know. There you go. I remember her. One of those girls was grabbing my ass for a while I was playing, so that was something that distracted me for sure. But she's, yeah, she's cool. She's getting down to fucking Dave Clark. Oh, are they making out? Damn, Mike, man. Really? What? You know, Mike's actually a super funny guy, but he can be so serious like that. That's Jejo. Yeah, that's Jejotronic. Oh my God, he loves that stuff. He plays regularly at Kit Kat Club, so he loves the Nipples situation. Friends having great music, and that's Jejotronic. Oh, I think, you know what happened? I think I remember. I'm...
Cause Apfelstein saves the day. He found the USB stick.
Yeah, yeah, right. So, ah, yeah. So that was pre-USB stick DJing for me. Cause you see my CDs there and the vinyl. And then he comes up with the fucking thumb drive, right? And I think we like said hi or hugged or I don't know, kissed. And it fell down. And I was like, then I got panicked because like, you know, he was supposed to play next. And so we all got down and we were looking for it. And then I found it. Yeah, we found it. I was relieved. I was like, what the fuck, man? All right, thanks everyone for watching. Thanks for coming to the shows, rocking with me. And I'll see you soon, I hope.